I think the people don't know that this is produced.
Welcome back to another reaction. Today we're gonna react to Tarasoy. He is probably the biggest star in beatbox right now. He brought the craziest videos. I don't wanna no book. If you play, keep it on the low. And he has a new video, The Hills, the Weeknd beatbox cover, new The Weeknd cover. So let's check it out. It just came out. I know it will be one of the craziest beatbox videos of all time again, because that's what Taras is doing right now. So without further ado, let's go.
Yeah, man on the clock, he doing promo. You said keep our business on the low. I'm just trying to get you out the friend zone. Cause you look even better than the photos. Now send me the info. Need to dress attention, yeah. I was coming since your friend's home. Keep on trying to hide it, but your friends, no, no, no. I only gon' give minutes. I'm the only girl that I'll be. Sorry, I only love it when you touch me.
Holy shit. Okay. He did it again. Oh my God, that's so good. And I know I had seen the comments. A lot of people are like,
it's fake. It's all fake. Don't you know it's produced? I think the people don't know that this is produced. They use effects on their voice.
Let me explain to you what he does here. He is using effects. Yeah. Oh my God, no. He's using reverb, delay, sometimes little bass synthesizer, a lot of compression, EQ. This is what you do in a professional production. This is, for example, what a lot of BBU participants do. This is what they actually do on all your Swiss beatbox videos. But normally on the like produce all beatbox international videos, all the beatbox videos you see on the internet that sound good have these treatments. He's not using autotune or if any, very, very little, because he's a phenomenal singer. And also these different voices, he's singing like this and singing like this and singing like this, but then with different effects and also very nice reverb. For example, when he has a, you can hear that there's a little, like a little bass synthesizer on it. Or like, yeah, but that's totally, totally normal. That's how you do to make a production sound good. You think when The Weeknd is singing the song in the beginning, he sings like this?
tossing me the info.
There's like a little distortion, a little telephone effect. This is what is there also in the original song. So is it pure beatbox? No, it's not. But for example, Taras also did a video on his channel where he showed... I didn't subscribe yet. Oh, Taras, no! Sorry! Yeah, where he showed that no mic, no editing, just his beatbox. And then you can say...
I don't wanna... No. If you bring me... Sleep it on the low. Cloud goes my heart. Stake it anymore. If you creep... Please don't let it show. Oh, baby.
Okay, it's no effects on it, it's just the phone, maybe a little compression, but a lot of people probably think why this is produced is because the effects are automated. What does it mean, Shazam? For example, in the Swiss beatbox videos or in the video, like in a lot of beatbox videos, also in your all your GBB wildcards. What? And Stitch didn't sound like... feels like nothing. Yes, yeah, also audio edited. If you have a raw audio, it sounds shit as shitty as shit, man. So, but what Taras does here, he's changing the effects on and off, which you all also do in like production. For example, sometimes he has a big reverb and sometimes the reverb is gone. For example, here you can see.
Pay the dress attention, yeah.
For example, tension. Yeah, and then you hear the, yeah, there's a delay on it, but the delay is not the entire time because then it would sound way too full and there was too much going on. He's using the effects sometimes on effects, and also when he's singing like this, not necessary to put a bass synthesizer on it because then it would sound like an octave, but he's only using it when he does the bass. So it sounds really good. He's basically doing, for example, when you have production, he is doing a synthesizer, he's doing drums, he's doing vocals, he's doing vocal effects. And normally when you produce a track, you produce the bass on itself, the drums on itself, the voice on itself, the voice effects on itself, and then you put it all together to make it sound cohesive. He is doing it all with his mouth. But the mic can't pick up everything like it is, so he needs to help a little bit, make the bass bassy like you would produce a bass, make the drums like you would produce the drums, like the voice, like voice. So this is very, very normal. This is what everyone did in BBU. This is what everyone does for his videos. This is what D-Lo does in his videos. That's what Codfish is doing in his videos. He, Taras, is just doing it very, very good. Like the best we've seen so far, maybe. And yeah, it doesn't sound like natural beatbox 100%. It sounds better. And this is also the style Taras wants to go for. If you ever saw Taras beatbox on stage, you know he's solid. He was at GBB last time with his crew. And he's Russian beatbox champion, if I'm not mistaken. He is one of the most powerful beatboxers in the world. He has so many unique techniques. So he's a good beatboxer. It's the same with Mad Twins. When I see people, oh, they're just produced. Yo, they're the best tech team in the world, probably. So what the
fish?
They won GBB. They have the craziest live performances. And Taras is the same. He can perform the shit live. Of course, it doesn't sound the same. When a singer performs a song live, it also doesn't sound the same. This is music. This is the magic of production. This is what we're used in radio. So, yeah, little rant here. Huge shout out to Taras. I think he is progressing the beatbox scene right now to a level that not a lot of people are doing. I know a lot of in the scene people like to hate on him. But he's bringing beatbox to the next level, bringing a lot of new ears and eyes to beatboxing right now. And he's doing a phenomenal job making music that people just like to listen to. Period. End. Nothing more to say. And also, this is like what like normal people like to listen to. Normal people don't like the all technical shit. They really like to hear like voices and nice bass and a nice composition. So yeah, without further ado, please, as I just did, awesome man, become a member of his channel and here come, bro. Because Taras bringing very crazy stuff to the beatbox scene. He is bringing beatbox to the new levels. So yeah, please support Taras Dhani on Instagram, TikTok, YouTube, everywhere. He's crazy, bring beatbox to the next level. He's so good. I love him. I can't wait to see him again. Much love to you and to everyone else. Please subscribe. You know the drill. And see you guys soon. I only call you when it's...